7 is 6 equals 4x plus 9y. Good start of problem here. Solving this for y. Okay, trying to get y by itself. Now treat y like you've always treated y when you solve for y. Okay, if there were things multiplied by y, there was a certain thing you would do to get y by itself. There was things added and subtracted to the y term. There are things that you would do in order to get those things canceled out. Right? So Grady, what would you do?
Minus y on both sides.
Minus y?
Or minus 9y.
Minus 9y. What's 9y minus 9y?
Zero.
Zero. What's 6 minus 9y?
6 minus
9y.
6 minus 9y.
Can't. Unflappable. Okay. So 6 minus 9y equals 4x. Now what would you do? Ready?
Minus 6 on both sides.
Okay, minus 6 on both sides. So we just have negative 9y on the side. And then we have 4x minus 6. Somebody besides Grady do this last thing. Yes?
Divide by 9.
9. What's negative 9 divided by 9?
Negative y.
Negative 1y. Johnny, you want to modify that a bit?
Okay, so negative
9 divided by negative 9 is now what?
1.
A positive 1, so then that's good. We like that, okay? Let me make more room here. So we have y. Good, we did it, right? And the other stuff is what it is. It's just what it is equal to. We could say 4x minus 6 over negative 9. You could say... I'm going to divide this by negative 9. I should divide everything by negative 9, right? That was the mistake we talked about yesterday. We're going to divide everything. We would not divide everything by what we were dividing the side by. Right, so we'll divide the 4 by negative 9. What's 4 divided by negative 9? Is it a positive or a negative number?
Negative.
It's a negative number. What would that number be as a fraction? John?
Y would negative 4 over 9.
4 over 9 times x. Negative 6 divided by negative 9 is going to be a positive or a negative?
Positive.
Positive. Positive what? Great.
6 over 9.
6 over 9. Can we simplify 6 over 9?
2 over 3.
2 over 3. Let's take a look back here. 2 thirds minus 4 times x. 2 thirds minus 4 times x. If your answer looks like a 4x minus 9 over negative 9, that's fine. It's a good place to be right now. We only just started doing this, right? I would like to see you simplify it. It's something that I difficult thing to do. But this is a perfectly fine, perfectly correct answer. Next, what was next?
10.
Thank you. Ten. 6y minus 1.5. I meant to do this also. The way Brady had us do it from the beginning was subtract 9 by both sides. Anybody do anything differently than that? Sean?
I think I left the 9y. I think I subtracted the 4.
Subtract the 4x?
Yeah.
So on this side we'd get 6 minus 4x.
Yeah.
And on this side we'd have 9y.
Yeah.
And then what would we do?
We divide by 9.
Divide by 9. You get 6 minus 4x over 9. A positive 9.
Yeah.
Right, so here we have a positive 9, 6, positive 6 divided by 9, a negative 4 divided by 9. Here we had a 4 divided by negative 9, which would come out the same. Here we had a negative 6 divided by negative 9, which would be the same as positive 6 divided by positive 9. The same thing. Just an alternate way to go. Solving for y. Jacob.
Add 1.5x.
I love it. 1.5x. Add 1.5x. 6y equals 0. 8 plus 0.5x. Okay. Charlie?
Divide by 6
and y equals 8 plus 1.5x over 6.
Great, we could also take 8 divided by 6 and get 4 thirds, right? Following that, simplifying 8 divided by 6 plus 3 halves divided by 6. 1.5 is 3 halves. Right, and we divide by 6, we're going to multiply instead by the reciprocal of 6, which is 1 sixth. Okay, the 3 and the 6 can cancel. That's 1, that's 2. So y equals 4 thirds plus, this is 1 over 2 times this, 1 fourth. If you took your calculator and divided 1.5 by 6, what do you think you're going to get? 1.5 divided by 6?
0.25.
1.5 divided by 6, 0.25. We know that's 1. 0.25x, that's fine. Okay? That was number 10. And let's get a regular size piece of paper now. The next one, the last one, is 23. What about the sphere? Can we find a sphere? Okay, so here's a sphere. The formula for the area, or the volume of a sphere, which we all remember from calculus, is 4 thirds pi r cubed. Okay. This is to solve for r cubed. Get r cubed by itself. Right? This entire thing, by itself, which is easier than getting r by itself. We just have to get r cubed by itself and stop. Okay, so how will we do that? Cancel out all the other stuff that's there somehow. Who knows, a grade you should probably shun?
Minus pi.
Minus pi?
About.
I would minus pi if I saw a plus pi, because positive pi and negative pi cancel each other out.
So,
Jacob?
Subtract 4 thirds.
I would subtract 4 thirds if I saw a blah 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 plus 4 thirds, then I would subtract 4 thirds.
Okay.
Okay. Subtraction is the opposite of addition. Is 4 thirds being added to the r cubed term? How is it interacting with the r cubed?
Multiply.
You gotta divide it. So you're gonna divide by what?
4 thirds.
Divide by 4 thirds. Okay, we know 4 thirds divided by 4 thirds is 1. I'm going to multiply by 3 fourths. Right? Multiply by the reciprocal. So 3 fourths times v equals what?
Pi times r cubed.
Pi times r cubed. Like I said, pi times r cubed. It tells us what pi is doing to r cubed. How would v cancel out the pi? Remember, pi is just a number. Monica?
Pi.
Divide by pi. Divide this by pi, happens to be multiplied by 1 over pi, so we divide by pi, so it's fractions involved. So we have 3 over 4 times pi times v equals r cubed. Or if we treat v as v over 1, we get 3v over 4 pi equals r cubed. One of those is fine. It says use guess, check, and revise to find the radius of the sphere. How could we possibly find the radius of the sphere? Do we have to know something?
The volume.
Volume? Do we know the volume?
Yes.
Yeah, you might not remember it. It says right here in the book, 381.51. 381.51. That is the volume. What are we going to do with that?
Multiply by.
Yeah, we're going to plug it into this little formula we've rewritten. So it means we'll multiply by 3, 1.51 over 4 pi. Okay, we should probably figure out what that number comes out to be. So I'll grab my calculator. That's your radio. 3 times 381.51. I'll divide that by, I'll put it in parentheses, 4 pi. So that number is 91.08, let's call it. So what does the radius have to do with 91.08? Is that what the radius is, Monica?
It's that number times
this number times itself 3 times? We're close. It's equal to r cubed, right? So how do I get that number if I know r? Cube this number? But don't I cube r? Right? Isn't it r times itself 3 times?
Yeah.
And once I multiply r by itself 3 times, what number would I get?
That number.
That number, 91.08. So what are we going to do?
Divide by 3.
Divide by 3. Wouldn't that be if we had a 3 times r?
Yeah.
And is 3 times r the same as r times itself 3 times?
Yes.
No.
Divide by the cube. Now that's a tricky thing, right? How do we
divide?
I mean, the tricky thing is how do we go backwards from cubing? It's not divided by a cube. You can't divide by an operation, right? You can divide by a number, but I don't think that's going to help us here. Donna, you got any ideas?
Do you go divided by 3 and then take the number that you divided by?
Idea, but do you think that there, like, if I had the number r, if the number r was 5, let's just say it was 5, would the number 3 be multiplied by that? Like, it would just be 5 times 5 times 5. Is 3 involved in that? No, I mean, the number 3 as far as 3 5s being multiplied together. Well, let's just use guess, check, and revise, right? Just guess, check, and revise. So what number do you think, if you multiply by itself 3 times, you would get 91.08? It didn't take long. Those numbers get pretty big. How about 2? What would be 2 cubed?
8.
2 times 2 is 8. How about that?
Oh, you're right.
What would 3 cubed be?
27.
Yeah. 3 times 3 times 3. Okay, we're not very close right now. What about 4? 4 cubed.
64.
5 cubed?
125.
Now that's too big.
So 4 point?
4 point something. See, this is what guess, check, and revise is. 4 point something.
4.5.
Let's try 4.5 cubed.
4.5.
91.125. That's pretty close. Should be
4.4.
4.4. Right. We just keep dialing it in. Oh, well, 4.4. What is the price? It's 4.4. Cubed is. Okay, so it's too much smaller than.
So 4.
But you get it, right? You're gonna dial it in. Oh, it's not 4.5. It's not 4.4. It's in the middle. 4.45. 4.49. I don't know. Let's just keep getting as close as we can to getting 91.08. But you don't need me to do it for you, right? You can do that. Okay. What do you think? How did it go? Let's do okay. Okay. Well then. Let's put everything away. Quick little quiz here, see if indeed you're correct. You did well and you're getting it. Zoom right there. Okay, we're going to solve for y, so someone help us out with that. We'll solve for y.
Subtract
2x from itself. Subtract 2x from itself. So I have 3y equals 7 minus 2x. Okay? Check it. Divide by 3. Divide by 3. Y equals 7 thirds minus 2 thirds x. Just divide everything by 3. Or 7 minus 2x over 3 is fine as well. As long as what you wrote is equal to this, that's correct. Okay, number 2. Tricky one. Please.
So 3x times, well, distribute the 3x.
Okay.
So that'd be 6x.
Okay.
Parentheses, 3x times 3y.
3x times 3y, just parentheses like this?
Yeah.
Like we're going to multiply this by that?
Oh.
We should be adding.
Okay,
equals 3. We could clean this up. We could say it is 3 times 3 is 9 times x times y. equals 13. Now what? Chop.
Subtract 6x from both sides.
Say again?
Subtract 6x from both sides.
Okay. Let's subtract the thing that's being added. Classic move. 9xy equals 13 minus 6y. Or sorry, 6x. Charlie?
Divide
9x
by 6.
Divide 9x. Y equals 13 minus 6x over 9x. We'll leave it just like that. Okay? What do you think about that? Maybe you didn't get it on the review, but then if it came up again. Do you remember that there's really a lot of similarities between what we did here and how we solve a normal equation that just has a bunch of numbers and one variable? Right? There's a lot of distributing, there's adding and subtracting, there's dividing. Right? That's all there is to it. Everybody go and grab here.